Hi, Kristen from Lenovo here. In this video, we will go over how to use Microsoft Teams on a ThinkSmart display powered by Android.
You can log into your Teams device by generating a code and inputting it on a desktop device with Microsoft Teams, or by entering your email and password. Once you've logged in, you will have access to the home screen. On the home screen, press the Contacts button to see recent contacts and search for someone in your directory. Press the Chat button to open up the chat menu. In a chat, click the three dots on the top right corner of the screen to switch between the chat, shared files, and view chat details, which allows you to mute notifications on a conversation. Press the Calendar button to open up your Microsoft Calendar. Click a scheduled item to join a meeting, view the meeting details, and set your RSVP status. Click the three dots in the top right corner to switch between the meeting chat, the meeting details, and view shared files under the More section. Clicking the More button on the home screen lets you access other features like viewing all of your shared files, Teams, sticky notes, and org charts. Clicking Reorder lets you change the order of the home screen buttons. On the right side of the screen, you can quickly view and access your voicemail, calendar, chat, calls, and Teams activity. Swiping to the final page lets you reorder your quick access menu, adding up to three features. Click Save to finalize any changes you make. To make a call on your device, click the Call button on the home screen. In the Call menu, on the left side of the screen is the Dial pad and Search function. On the right side of the screen, you can view your speed dial, call history, and voicemail. You can set a contact as your speed dial in the Calls section of your Microsoft Teams desktop app. To make a call from your speed dial, simply select the icon of the person you want to call.
Here's Justin to explain the different in-call settings.
Thanks, Kristen. While in a call, you can view participants, allowing you to manage and add people to the call. View the chat, send an emoji or virtually raise your hand, share the screen of a USB-C connected external device, change the participant view mode, disable or enable your camera, mute your microphone, or adjust your speaker audio. Pressing the three dots brings up more settings, like disabling chat bubbles, putting yourself on hold, recording the meeting, turning on live captions, turning off incoming video, and accessing the dial pad. Back to you, Kristen.
Thanks, Justin. Back on the home screen, when you click your profile, you can pull up a side menu where you can set your availability status, connect a device, toggle notifications, access settings, and lock the device. In the Settings menu, you can adjust notification settings and set a quiet time. Manage Teams delegates. View your company profile. Adjust chat settings by toggling read receipts and suggested replies. Access your ringtones and block calls with no caller ID in the calling settings. Set a device PIN. Set when your device screen times out. Change your device wallpaper. Set when the device auto restarts. Report an issue. View the About section for the device. Sign out of your device and access more device settings. In device settings, you can change your device language. Set the time and date. Adjust the brightness level, screen timeout, and toggle adaptive brightness in the display settings. Click Accessibility to view and toggle accessibility features that might come with your device, like high contrast mode, large text mode, and screen color correction. Plus, view any downloaded services you might have on the device. Under volume, you can individually set the ring volume, calls volume, and music volume of your device. Camera settings will let you adjust any compatible camera that might come with your device. Some devices might come with a mode switch option to toggle a Teams display between Teams and an external peripheral mode. You can also power off and reboot the device from the device settings menu. You can find your current IP address, MAC addresses, serial number, firmware version, and any other relevant device information in the About section. In the Network and Connectivity section, you can set your device Wi-Fi and pair and view connected Bluetooth devices. And under the Security section, you can set Face ID on compatible devices. If you are a device admin, you can access the admin settings with the admin password created when the device was set up. In the admin settings, you can change the debug settings and access network configuration options. If you want to learn more about your Lenovo Smart Collaboration device, subscribe to Lenovo Support on YouTube or go to smartsupport.lenovo.com.